Welcome back, Crip Campers, and a huge hello to President Barack Obama.
Hello, everybody, and hello, Andrea. I was hoping to see if there were going to be any s'mores. I guess virtually that's hard to do. One of the first films that we were lucky enough to be able to produce was Crip Camp.
Scenes from Camp Jeanette.
It was so moving to us to see all these young people, teenagers at Camp Jeanette who left camp believing they could lead a worldwide movement, finding their voice and awakening to their power.
Andrea Levant.
Bringing the Crip Camp story to life means so much to our community.
What I want to do is hear from you about what camp's been like.
You have joined us on our sixth week of Crip Camp.
Hi, everyone.
We're continuing the work you see in the film with leaders of today's movement.
Always like to start with the spirit of gratitude.
We have over 8,500 people registered to join us for camp each week from all over the world.
People using sign language.
Making sure everyone feels included is our priority. This includes folks who are deaf and hard of hearing.
Image description, okay.
And blind and low vision.
A dress with a black top.
I have heart-shaped glasses.
Short curly hair.
I'm wearing a denim shirt. There's a picture of me swimming in Hawaii, which is where I was born. My hair is much grayer than it was just a few years ago.
President Obama, I think that there's somebody that you wanted to bring in as well.
Somebody who has helped to make unbelievable change in this country and around the world, and who just happens to have been featured in Crip Camp.
We want no more segregation.
How are you, Judy?
Judy Human.
Welcome, Mr. President, how are you?
How do you see the relationship between activism and protest and social movements and government?
We learned very early on that we needed to learn how laws were made, how they're implemented, how to work with our city government, our school boards. We would never have been successful if it wasn't for coalitions.
Historic footage.
Funding from Section 504 has led to sweeping changes in transportation, healthcare, education, and job opportunities.
I can't imagine a more important story to tell. Our greatest progress has always come from the ground up.
Scenes of protest.
That's how the 504 sit-ins happened. That's how the ADA happened.
The passage of this monumental legislation will make it clear that our government will no longer allow the largest minority group in the United States to be denied equal opportunity.
I was proud to celebrate the 20th anniversary of the ADA at the White House 10 years ago. Now, as we celebrate the 30th anniversary, we have to remember the hard work and sacrifice it took to win those battles, so it gives us courage for the battles that remain.
1990 Capitol crawl.
Right now, when we're in the middle of a pandemic, at a time when people around the country are waking up to the systemic racism that so often has excluded people, Crip Camp with film and the work that all of you are doing reminds us that when people get involved and they recognize their own power, they can achieve extraordinary change.
You can join the Crip Camp Virtual Experience at cripcamp.com. Netflix.